All right, in this video I'm going to be tying up a soft hackle shad fly. This is more of a technique of fly tying rather than a specific pattern. And I've sort of been obsessed with soft hackle wet flies for a little while, and I feel like it's an underutilized pattern for shad. I've started tying them up specifically for shad and have quickly started to fill my fly boxes with them. So they're effective patterns. They're kind of impressionistic rather than looking specific to something in the river, but it kind of could be mistaken for just about anything in the river. I also like them because the materials to tie them are cheap. You're typically using either hen or guinea fowl, which is what I'm going to be using in this video. Hungarian partridge might be a little more expensive, but there's a multitude of different materials that you can tie these with. For this particular fly, I like to tie it with a 2x long hook. So in the vise, I have a Daiki 1710, and that's a size 8. I'm going to be tying this fly with 6-aught Uni Thread and pink. So to start the fly, I'm going to start a good 2 eye lengths behind the eye. You want to leave some room because we're going to tie on some bead chain at the end of the fly. So I'm just going to take my thread down to the barb. And then I'm going to tie in some medium oval tinsel. And I need probably about 6 inches of that. And I like to tie that in at the butt and just leave a tag long enough to come all the way up to your tie-in point. And then we'll bring our thread back down. And this is going to be used for ribbing, but I also like to just take a couple of turns with it behind where we're going to be tying the body, just to create a little butt, and then just tie that off. And I just kind of angle it back and tie a couple of wraps there. To make the body, I'm going to be using some Mylar Tinsel. I've got some pink here. This is a fairly fine diameter, so I'm just going to peel off probably 2 feet or so, maybe more like 36 inches, 2 to 3 feet. And then what I like to do is just fold that in half, fold it in half one more time. And then fold that in half around your thread. And that'll just help you more quickly build up a body. And we'll just advance our thread back up to the tie-in point. And then just start wrapping our body with the tinsel. Should be enough to bring it back down. That's right, if you have a couple short ones there, you can just come back and trim those out. We'll pick it up on the way back up. And we'll just capture with our thread. and snip away the excess. Now I'm just going to take my oval tinsel here and wrap the body. And we'll capture that with our thread. There's probably enough oval tinsel there to do a second fly. Might not need quite 6 inches. All right, so now to protect that body, I'm just going to touch it with some Sally Hansen's, and that'll just protect the body, protect the tinsel, and make a more durable fly. Alright, so we'll just go ahead and let that dry. Okay, our body is dry, and you can see it's a nice kind of, I don't know, traditional looking, almost like a salmon type pattern, style body. I just think they're elegant looking. Simple, yet elegant. So I'm just going to build up a couple wraps, in front of our body here, and it just helps us to tie in our hackle. For the hackle, I'm going to be using a pink dyed guinea fowl feather, and you can pick up kind of a loose pack of those feathers from craft stores, and actually there are some decent feathers in here. It's definitely some usable feathers. you can pick them up in fly shops for sure, and if you look on eBay, you can get them in a ton of different colors, usually $4 or $5 for 100 different colors. So I've got this guinea feather prepared, and I want some of the longer barbs, so I'm going to tie this in by the tip, but a fairly large tip is going to be cut off. And you want to tie this in up on your bump. A couple good tight wraps, and then we'll trim away the excess. Go ahead and bring my thread forward. A little straggler there. All right, so what we want to do is just kind of wet your fingers, and you want to stroke those hackle fibers back. Try to get them all to lay back, and just take your time. You're almost folding the barbs in half across the stem, and you just want to get them all to lay backwards, back towards the bend of the hook. And we're really just going to make maybe two wraps. You can tie it in as thick as you want, but I prefer them kind of sparse. So that was one full wrap. And I'm going to take a second wrap. And again, you're just trying to stroke all those fibers back as you're doing this. And then we'll capture.
and then just snip away the excess. Now I'm just going to pull all the barbs back and just make a couple wraps in front, and that'll just kind of help them lay down. That looks pretty good. And again, you can tie them as thick as you want. I tend to tie them sparse. Just think it looks buggier. And sometimes simpler is better. I'm just going to tie up a little bit of a thread mump here. And I'm going to tie in some bead chain. Try to do that without capturing any of my hackle fibers, which can be a little difficult, but just take your time. Flip it over and build some shoulders. And then we'll just build up a small head. And whip finish. And that is a soft hackle shad fly. I just think they're great flies, very simple, very elegant. You can tie them with different materials and different colors. Just a great looking, simple fly.